Get in close, packing around so that everyone can see.
That's freaking crazy.
Okay, you guys. I'll just show you this. This is what these fish eat, okay? Looks like catfish. No, this is actually made of the same product as the other, the same base material, but there's less protein in here and fat for the larger fish, okay? Now these guys are 5 years old, and they were eggs in the hatchery here 5 years ago. In fact, almost 6 years ago. These guys are from the... Okay. So I'll throw a little bit of food in and we'll see if they're going to eat, alright? Because these fish are in spawning condition right now, they don't usually eat very much at all. Normally salmon, when they're in spawning mode, they don't feed naturally. So I don't know if they'll eat very much. I just want to point out something else in here. There's males and females in here, so they're mature. And they exhibit differences in their body shape and form when they mature. So you may have seen pictures of male salmon. They get a hook jaw. Their jaws kind of get a change shape. Yeah. So the females don't change. So there's a couple of fish in here that are obviously males, but it must be over there. They're over there, okay. That have a very obvious hook jaw and they're smaller. Alright? Yeah, this guy's coming over here. Alright? So you can see that? That's normal. That's a normal change in the fish. Oh yeah. Okay, so these fish in here are 5 years old. Salmon can live to be 10 to 12 years old, Atlantic salmon. And these fish would weigh 10 to 15 pounds. The record Atlantic salmon for Lake Ontario from before the 1900 was 40 pounds. They can get to be bigger than 60 pounds, actually. Now that's a rare fish, but they can get that big. Right. So that's 4 or 5 times as big as these guys in here. So I'll throw a little bit of food in and we'll see. I don't know if they'll eat anything or not. They might. Oh, yeah. Okay. He's going right at it. They like you. All right. There we go.
Yeah.
Kiss it. Kiss it.
Kiss it.
You see, we're feeding them floating food because they eat fairly slowly off the surface, so we don't want it going to the bottom, right? For these guys in here. Okay. Any questions so far?
I had a comment but a question. This guy right here?
Yeah.
Is he blind?
No.
No? Does he just like the size then? He's like he's hanging around there. But how would he get fish? Is that a sand pot?
Fish have different color variations, and actually Atlantic salmon, after they spawn, turn fairly dark, and they sort of have a recovery period. So that fish down there is showing those characteristics, right?
Yeah, for sure.
What happened to the fly?
Yeah.
How much energy does it take to run a place like this to like circulate all the water and all that sort of stuff?
Like actually, it costs about $18,000 a year for hydro. Yeah. That's what you mean. Yeah, I can tell you how many kilowatts it is. I've got it all written down. Yeah, it takes a fair amount.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay, do you want to come over to this tank here and I'll show you these guys as well?
I'll wait for the end guys to back in so everyone can see.
Yeah. These are 1 and 2 year old Atlantics, okay? So you can see, you remember the fish in the aquarium? The smaller fish in this tank are a year older. So you can get a sense of how fast they grow, all right? These fish are mostly immature, but there's the odd male in here that has a pipe on his jaw, bottom jaw. So some males mature earlier, all right? Not usually the females.
Where do you get your food,
huh?
Where do you get your food, guy, right now?
Well, there's a few commercial suppliers that make it in Canada.
Like make it here?
Well, he doesn't manufacture food. But he runs a fish farm up north in Manitoulin, right?
Yeah, sure.
You know him?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. He raised rainbow fish.
Yeah. Big place. I know him.
Okay, so I'm going to throw a little bit of food in here, okay? Now, the difference is that there's more fish in this tank. Mind you, there's only about 50, I think. But these fish are feeding a little more actively because they're not mature. So they're a little hungrier. And they put...
There'll be more sedate around them. You can just relax.
Yeah. So what happens when we put the floating feed in here is they come to the surface and they'll target, if there's 10 pellets right here and one over there, Atlantic salmon will target one pellet and go for it no matter if there's some closer. So you can kind of watch them come over and grab that one pellet. They might come from this side of the tank all the way over to the other side. All right? So let's see what happens here. These guys are feeding a little more actively than the others. Here goes. You ready? What happened?
What happens if the water goes in your mouth?
Die.
Fish juice. Oh, soaking my camera. Oh, not good.
Okay.
Sorry about that. That's my fault.
That's his fault. Yeah. He wanted to see that. But that's part of working the fish hatcher here. You don't wear your dirty clothes, as you can see. All right. So what I can invite you to do is have a look around the facility. Those two guys over there know a little bit about what's going on in here. And we've got some of our production fish in the tanks back here. There's about 5,000 or 6,000 fish in each tank. And if you've got any questions, I'll answer them for you. Okay?